I uploaded 2500 designs on Redbubble, and today I'm going to share with you the amount of money I made as a beginner in 1 year. I will also answer the question, is it worth it to sell on Redbubble? So let's get started. Redbubble was actually my first online business. It's an online marketplace that allows artists to showcase their designs on a wide range of products like t-shirts, stickers, mugs, phone cases, and many more. But don't worry, you don't have to be an artist to sell on Redbubble. If you know how to use Canva, Photoshop, or AI generators, you can start selling immediately. It's a print-on-demand platform, meaning that the products are only manufactured when a customer places an order, which reduces inventory costs and risks for sellers. In simpler words, all you have to do is design and upload your images. The rest are being taken care of by Redbubble. If you saw my previous videos, you'll know that I'm a football/soccer fan, so I made designs about football. Redbubble allows us to upload up to 6 designs a day, and I challenge myself to upload 60 designs a day to increase my chances of selling something. When you upload a design, you need to make sure that your SEO is good. Just set the title to something searchable. Imagine, what would you type to find this product? In this case, it's a cute duck with a hat. Don't go the artistic way and name it something like Dolly the duck going for a walk to see her friends in the lake. No one is searching that. You get the point. Use tags that are searchable and use all the tags that Redbubble allows you to use, and write a very short description or ask ChatGPT to write you one. You have to enable every single product and take the time to fit the design nicely into the product. You will lose a lot of customers if you don't do this. Uploading 60 designs is a very boring process, and it took me 1 or 2 hours a day to complete it. I did that for a month, and I saw that my store was starting to attract people. Then I uploaded a couple of designs a day until December. This was the period when I uploaded my last designs to my store. I stopped because my Etsy account was going well and I wanted to focus only on Etsy. But this turned out to be a good experiment to see if I'm still able to earn passive income after 7 inactive months. Let's see the analytics of my store. Remember, these are realistic and beginner-friendly results. I started my shop on the first day of August in 2022, and in my first month I made 15 euros, which isn't a lot, but I was so happy that I made my first money online. In September, I had a slight improvement with a 20 euro profit. But in October, things started to take off. I doubled my profit with 50 euros, and I knew that I was going to be rich.
Okay.
Then in November, I hit 3 figures and made almost 165 euros. December was my best month because people spend a lot on gifts for Christmas. I made 250 euros. Then, as I said before, I stopped posting new designs. In January, I made 83 euros, which is good for an inactive month. February was better with almost 100 euros. In March, I hit 3 figures again, with 120 euros. And from now on, we see a consistent pattern. In April, 96 euros. In May, 73 euros. In June, 133 euros. And so far in July, 84 euros. In total, in 1 year of selling on Redbubble, I made 1190 euros, which is almost an average of 100 euros or $110 a month. The funny thing is that 300 euros came from only one design. One of 2500 designs brought me the 1/4 of my income. Look at the difference. This is my second best seller. I know that 100 bucks a month is basically nothing, but since I already planted this money tree, it is good to have some extra bucks to buy some clothes or anything else. And the good thing about Redbubble is that you can't lose any money because it's free to upload designs. The only thing you can lose is your time. The bad thing is that it's very saturated, and Redbubble leaves you with a small amount of profit per se. Also, they recently added account tiers, which determined if you're going to make less money than usual or not. My account is premium, so I make the same amount of money as before. Basically, Redbubble ranks your account. If your account is standard, then it means that your designs aren't original enough or that you have a small number of designs and sales. If your account is premium, it means that your store is going in the right direction. And if you are a pro, then you are actually making money on Redbubble. Is it worth it to sell on Redbubble? Redbubble? I'm going to be completely honest with you. If you are a beginner and you've never made any money online, then I think you should give it a try. You're going to gain a lot of experience. But if you do give it a try, you should at least upload 1000 designs unless you are a great artist. Nobody's going to fund you with 10 designs on Redbubble. Don't even bother to open your shop if you're not willing to put in the effort. But 1000 designs are still not enough. I made another shop in September with over 1300 designs and I only made 6 euros. My niche wasn't the best and my designs got lost in the last pages of the results. Pick a good niche and double down on the designs that you sell. If you sold before or you are a pro seller, you shouldn't sell on Redbubble. It's better to sell on Etsy and it's even better if you make your own website. I lost my Etsy account but I still didn't get back to uploading on Redbubble because I knew that I had the experience to focus on something else that would make me more money. Also, you can test your designs on Redbubble to see how they perform if you want. My best seller on Redbubble was my best seller on Etsy as well. It's not a coincidence. Overall, I don't think that selling on Redbubble is the best idea. You know everything about Redbubble now. It's your choice to take action or not.